Good morning. Welcome to Weekly Singapore Stocks with Jonathan. Today is 15th of July 2012. What do we have last week? Last week, we have the European fears. It started with the week where everyone was so fearful, market came down. We end off with a week with a bull bang. We started off with the week with Alcoa earnings, not so good. But we end off with a week with JP Morgan, fantastic earnings. And that's what happened to Dow Jones. Dow Jones went up 204 points. What a volatile week last week. Okay, so what did we found out there last week? Last week, surprisingly, we found out that the banks, by hook or by crook, they will find whatever ways to make money. And not surprisingly, Fed knew about it since 2008. Oh well, whatever ways they want to find ways to make money, they will do it regardless of who cares about the regulation, who cares about the laws. It ain't illegal until someone found out about it, isn't it? Okay, now what do we have in the market? Let's take a look at S&P, SPY, which is an ETF that track S&P. If you notice that it is a startup with a week, came all the way down, it closed bang. We close off the week with, let's show the weekly chart. Well, not much of a change. We got a hanging man look-alike candle after 2 weeks ago, which is a shooting star look-alike candle. Now, what do we have? Let's see. Oops. Previously, if you're watching the YouTube, you knew that was a bullish divergence. The market went up. There was a bearish divergence right here in the MACD histogram, and also a small one in RSI before market came lower. Is this a sign that market is going to come lower? We shall see, but not yet. Now, what do we have, like it or not? S&P definitely is a higher high and of course a higher low. So we are still uptrend. Uptrend is still intact. Okay, so resistance to watch out for right now would be at about here, 137. Support to watch out for, 132, 130. And of course, the all-time support would be about 127. Breaking above 137, the very strong resistance would be at about 142. Okay, so watch out for S&P on that. Now, if you look at moving average, well, the moving average are a little bit of a Maggie Me, zigzag, zigzag, zigzag. So right now, like it or not, we are above the 200 day, market is still bullish. We are higher high, higher low, S&P as of now is still bullish. Okay, now, let's look at Euro dollar. Good sign about Euro dollar. If I zoom in very closely, okay, we have a hammer lookalike on Thursday, hammer lookalike on Friday, and on Friday hammer lookalike also a bullish engulfing. Okay, so in other words, short term wise, Euro US dollars looks like rebounding to go higher. If that's happened, market may go even higher. Okay, now in terms of gold, bad news was it's still within the descending triangle. That's the bad news. Good news, we have a hammer on Thursday. Okay, so short term wise, we could be having a rebound. So if we do have a rebound, watch out to see if we can close convincingly above this downward sloping trend line. Okay, so that means there's a possibility that the descending triangle may fail. Failure of a bearish candle is bullish. Next, we shall take a look at Shanghai. Oops, wrong chart. Shanghai, nice rebound from a critical support right here. Okay, 2140. Now, if this do rebound higher, there's a possibility that Shanghai may be forming a double bottom. Okay, if that does happen. So watch out to see Shanghai may bounce off from a double bottom. But like it or not, let me erase the line so it's easier to see. The resistance to watch out for right now would be 2250. So Shanghai would have to break that resistance at 2250, which is also a prior support and a prior resistance. Like it or not, look at all the moving average, it's all diving lower. So Shanghai is in a very strong downtrend. Now, the bad news, well, not the bad, sorry, the good news, there's a bullish divergence in MACD histogram, and no, only bullish divergence in MACD histogram. So that's the good news. Okay, so let's take a look at the Thailand Stock Exchange. It's been drifting higher and higher, but the bearish divergence is still intact in MACD histogram, although it's not being seen in RSI and stochastic. Okay, now like it or not, Friday candle is bullish. It engulfed the black candle on Thursday, so we shall see. The resistance to watch out for will still be the resistance high, previous high at about 1340. Okay, coming lower, watch out, the support will be at about 1175. Next support would be at about 1150. Okay, now in terms of FBM KLCI is very similar to Thailand Stock Exchange, but FBM KLCI right now, it is very close to the all-time high that was achieved on Wednesday, the all-time high. Okay, let's see, confirm 1632 and 1632.94. Well, sorry, the all-time high was on Thursday, but there's bearish divergence right now in MACD histogram and RSI. Okay, so be very careful. Like it or not, we are also at overbought stage. So right now, don't wake up the bears in FBM KLCI. It's drifting higher and higher. Okay, so keep quiet about that. Don't wake up the bears. Okay, now let's take a look at Straits Times. Straits Times. Whew. Fantastic movement. It cleared this falling window as a resistance, and right now is looking out to clear this resistance at about 3030. Okay, that was the previous time that it couldn't break higher. Why it couldn't break higher previously? Very simple. There is a very big falling window right there. 3030 to 3100. That is a 70 point falling window. So it's coming close to that resistance. Okay, now the good news, as compared with Malaysia and Thailand, it doesn't have any bearish divergence, but it is at RSI overbought, stochastic also overbought. Okay, now looking at moving average, we have two moving average right here, which is a very strong support if it goes lower, and if it comes lower, these two moving average could act as a support too. And if it does go lower, which I don't think so, because Monday high probability is going to do a gap up, high chance the gap up will break the 3000, but I don't foresee breaking the 3030 soon. Okay, unless massive good news. Okay, like it or not, do take note, after such a massive run higher, oops, for Dow Jones, profit taking could be expected on Monday night in Dow Jones. So Dow Jones may be consolidating on Monday night, so we shall see. Straits Times can still break above the 3030, but maybe, well, anything can happen. Okay, anything can happen. So high chance we're gonna go above 3000 on Monday morning. Okay, now let's take a look at banks. Funny thing about banks, UOB. Okay, now let's do OCBC first. OCBC broke the resistance. Okay, and we are just cleared this falling window. So OCBC has one more falling window right there. Okay, the OCBC next falling window price will be about 923 to about 935, about 10 cents. Okay, now OCBC, if you take a look clearly, it is a solid white candle. UOB, well, it ran before, and now you can say that it's forming a bullish pennant. Okay, but DBS, funny thing is, it couldn't move. On Friday, it formed a shooting star when Straits Times was so bullish. So watch out to see if there's a failure of this shooting star, if market is going to go higher. Or is DBS trying to tell us something? We shall see. Okay? Right, get or not, DBS is still below resistance of $14.20. Okay, so watch out. Okay, use this perhaps as a gauge. Now, I'll come to summary in a short while because I somehow the chart looks a little bit weird. Commodity this time, First Resources is participating, but I discount that because First Resources is a very low volume counter. But look at Noble Group. STI rallied. Noble Group wasn't rallying. Noble Group, if it closed below 1095, it doesn't look good. Because if it closed below 1095, we will have a descending triangle look-alike pattern. Okay? Olam, look at it. Tiny itty bitty candle. Okay, now Olam also have a descending triangle look-alike pattern. Okay, Sakari, when market so bullish, Sakari go turn out black candle. Well, Sakari, if it goes below $1.33. It's not a good sign. Okay, so be very careful. This high volume, black candle, very suspicious. So like it or not, commodity is not participating in this run higher. And what else can participate? Let's take a look at Marines. Marines, Ezra, very bad earnings report. Initially, thought that perhaps 1085 resistance broken can turn support, cracked easily, just cracked through, couldn't even hold. So Ezra right now is extremely bearish. Sembcorp bullish, it broke through the resistance. Look at Sembmarine at resistance. Look at Capricorp near resistance, which is also the falling window. Okay, now look at NOL, not participating. Look at Costco, not participating. I mean the candle, STI bullish, but Costco not participating. Yang Zijiang, black candles are more, not participating. But the good news about Yang Zijiang, at least you got three moving average trying to support Yang Zijiang right now. Breakthrough doesn't look good if we break below. Okay, so Marines, Sembcorp is participating, Sembmarine, Capricorp is trying to participate. Okay, now what move the market? Oh, I come to Plantation first. Wilma not participating. Indo Agri not participating. Golden Agri a little bit, but still at resistance. Okay, Wilma, if it breaks below 352, not a good sign. Okay, not a good sign. It may test the next support, would be at about $3.40 if it breaks $3.52. Like it or not, it's below all the moving average. Okay, now what move the market? Properties, especially F&N. Whew, what a cheerleader, pull the market a lot higher. Okay, CDDEF participating, but still at resistance. Capital Land still at resistance. Capital Land still at resistance. Okay, now what move are the Singtel? What move the Straits Times? Also Singtel, Telco. Now, let me give a summary a little bit earlier. You notice that this time, STI goes a lot higher as selective sectors, selective counter within selective sectors. The several counters that actually broke out the resistance, and continue to run higher, which pulled Straits Times higher. But not a lot of counters are participating, and a lot of counters right now are also at resistance. So what does it mean? If Straits Times is going to be bullish, those counter at resistance will have to break higher. So you're going to use, if you're thinking of longing, you're going to use a breakout strategy. Okay? If those counters cannot break resistance, like it or not, if all those counters that broke higher start to retrace and break below, it's a failure of a breakout. It is not that bullish. So right now we are at the edge. Overall, STI saying yes, we are bullish. But right now, a lot of counter at resistance. And if those counter at resistance can break higher, STI is going to go higher. But if those counter cannot break higher, and those counter that broke up now start to come back and pull, break, I mean, reverse the breakout, not that good sign. So these are the market that we need to pay attention to. Okay? Now, several counter you need to pay attention to right now is Genting. Highlighted the Genting. $1.38 must hold. Genting broke below $1.38, so not so good news. Now, the good news is we are now very close to the $1.30 to $1.35 rising window support, which have not tested before. Okay, that's for Genting. Now, SIA Engineering. Do take note that SI Engineering could be forming a Christmas tree, evening star. Okay, do take note only if it does go lower. StarHub, Telco, Singtel, StarHub will have to follow Singtel. Previously highlighted that it was a massive shooting star. It's a one-day wonder. On a Friday, went up higher. Now, it is still in play. This shooting star is still in play unless StarHub can go above $3.75. Then the shooting star has failed. Okay, watch out for that. Hyflux previously had a shooting star right here on Friday. Collapse. Okay, now do take notes in summary. You may have seen it, you may have heard it, me repeating over and over again, STI right now is overbought, has been overbought. Look at Hyflux chart, look at Straits Times, look at a lot of counters. It's been overbought for quite some time. Overbought can stay overbought, but right now the risk is a lot higher than last week, like it or not. But if you still want to take the risk, do remember, long small, run fast. That's the only thing I can tell you. Watch your stop loss really carefully. Okay, I'm expecting a certain market movement, hopefully. Oh, do remember, hoping my uncle Bradley will make an appearance sometime around July 28th. That's the major Bradley turn date. Hopefully he does show up. I'm watching it very closely to see if he does show up. He show up 1 week earlier. Before that, maybe he will show up 1 week earlier, before July 28th, or maybe he show up 1 week later. Anything can happen, plus minus. Okay. Now, if you'd like to find out more, go to my website chartingacademy.com. Do share my website with your friends. Okay. If they like to know more about how to do chart readings, and if you're not joined my mailing list, I have not sent out my mailing list for quite some time, mainly because there's really not much of a market movement. It's just following exactly. But if I see something, I'll send out alert to general mailing list. Okay? If you'd like to find out more about my inner circle, whereby I looked after a selected group of traders, that's the information you can find out about inner circles. So I wish you all the very best, and be very careful this week, especially when this week, Monday, not much news. But Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday onwards, there's going to be news. Especially on Wednesday, 10 p.m. Singapore time, Uncle Ben is going to speak. Okay, market may react. So you're going to have a volatile week again this week. Plus, this week is also the third week of the month. This is also the option expiration week. A lot of news, option expiration, this is going to be one very volatile market. Okay, so be careful and be safe in your trading. Thank you.